This is a production of PBS 39.
Companies have some time to figure out how to deal with an aging workforce. But in Allentown, folks hope they aren't gray when courthouse renovations are complete. When driving through the city these days, you can't miss the renovations at the Lehigh County Courthouse. Drill sounds and jackhammers have become the new soundtrack to downtown. But what's really happening, and when will it be done? Crystal Fisher spent some time with city officials to find some answers about changes at the new and old courthouse.
In 1812, Lehigh County's boundaries were defined. 5 years passed, and the settlers erected the Lehigh County Courthouse. 200 years later, the structure still stands.
It's been renovated a couple times, notably during the Civil War, and then again early in the 19th century, when they added an expanded area out in the back.
Well, the old courthouse is a wonderful treasure.
A brief walk into one of the two courtrooms, and you'll see firsthand the city's devotion to preserving the courthouse. Freshly polished wood carvings, recently restored jury benches, and old-fashioned light fixtures make up just a few of its majestic features. Follow the stairs down to the lower level and step back in time. William Burnt, the deputy court administrator, pointed out to us that the underground holding cells weren't nearly, let's say, as clean as they are today. Originally, they were merely stone and dirt with no ventilation.
Now, one would hope that you didn't incarcerate people here for years.
Never thought I'd say this, but kind of makes you appreciate modern-day prison cells.
The courthouse was outgrown in the early 20th century, and then they planned for this building.
It would have been nice when they built the new courthouse in the 1960s that they built it in the model of the historic courthouse.
This building has leaked, I'm told, essentially since it was brand new.
After the engineers looked at it, it was because the granite panels, which are very heavy, crushed the flashing around the panels themselves.
The crushed sealant created modern-day issues like this. Towels-lined soaked windowsills and water-damaged paint can be seen throughout the building. Not to mention the pipes. The leaks quickly turned into mold, and the mold turned into an air quality issue. The city realized the time to change had arrived. Driving down Hamilton, drilling noise is unavoidable, and construction crowds cars.
The project that was ready to be built essentially would more than likely have finished somewhere in the, I would say, $80 to $90 million range, and so we've reduced it considerably.
Don Cunningham, the county executive, pushed to pare back the plan $20 million by refining what he called opulent.
The original design called for an eight-story atrium. It called for courthouses that were two stories in ceiling height.
We toned it down. We put appropriate and nice finishes in those places where they needed to be.
They're storing squares of granite like these in a Parks Department warehouse in Allentown to reuse in the exterior of the new courthouse to cut costs again.
The money saved by cutting costs on the project will go towards fixing city bridges like this one on Linden Street and building a new emergency dispatch center in an old Wachovia building. But not everyone agrees with cutting costs. Judge Kelly Bannock believes if we're undergoing such major renovations, we should prepare for the future.
It won't be as serviceable for as long a period of time as I think we thought it needed to be.
The county executive believes the cutbacks were necessary.
While it's $20 million less, is the same amount of square footage as the original proposed building. Understand that what was taken out of the building was basically airspace.
We all try and have a positive attitude about it. I think we look down the road looking forward to an improved building.
The renovations at the courthouse are going very well. We're on time. Right now we're on time and we're under budget.
City officials predict the project will be completed by 2010. And should the needs of the court outgrow the size of the renovated building, there's always the option of using the old courthouse right across the street. For Tempo, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.